In this lab demonstration, I want to show you the different workflows or ways of working with Cloud Run. Cloud Run is a serverless platform for running highly scalable containers. Anything that runs in a container and listens for requests can run in Cloud Run. And the platform can go to planet scale in just seconds in response to peaks in demand and back down to zero instances when required to save you money. As we'll see shortly, Cloud Run has a container-based workflow and a source-based workflow. So the objectives of this lab demonstration are to create a simple Hello World app that can be deployed as a serverless, stateless container. We'll first demonstrate the container-based workflow, where we build a container and deploy it to Cloud Run, and then demonstrate the source-based workflow, where we just concentrate on our code and Cloud Run builds the container for us. So here we have a pretty basic Hello World app. I've chosen to write this app in Go, but as I said, you can choose any programming language you like, as long as it runs in a container. My app will listen on port 8080 and respond with a Hello World message. Using the container-based workflow means I need to build a container to deploy to Cloud Run, so I've also created a Docker file. As you can see, this is a two-part Docker file, where I use one image to build my binary and another image to actually run it. This is a very common pattern for building containers with Go. I can use cloud build to build my container image with the gcloud builds submit command. And I'll tag the container image Hello World. My code is uploaded to the Cloud Build service, which then builds the container image and stores it in the container registry. Now my container image is built, and I can view my image in container registry with gcloud container images list, and there it is. One of the nice things about working in the Cloud Shell inside the Google Cloud Console is I have Docker installed and running locally, so I can test my container image from here with Docker run. Docker will first retrieve my container image from container registry and then start running it for me. I can use the built-in web preview feature of the Cloud Shell to view the web service of my running container. And that seems to be working nicely. So let's deploy it to Cloud Run. I can do this with the gcloud run deploy command. I'll use --image to specify the container image to run. And that's it. As this is my first deployment, I'll specify a name for my service. It's suggesting Hello World based on my container image name. And it's now asking me to choose if I want to allow unauthenticated invocations. This is really important. Cloud Run services are secure by default. If I want to run my HTTPS endpoint as a web service that's open to the world, I must specify to allow unauthenticated invocations. Cloud Run will now create my new service and set up the traffic and IAM policy. The command returns with the service URL of my new Cloud Run service. I can also view this in the Cloud Run section of the Cloud Console. And here's my deployed service. As you can see, the container-based workflow is super easy to use and it gives us full control over the container image that's deployed in our service. But sometimes, maybe we don't want the hassle of having to create the container image ourselves. So Cloud Run also supports a source-based workflow. Let me show you how that works. First, I'll delete my existing Cloud Run service. And I'll delete my container image from container registry. This isn't necessary. I just want to show you that I'm not cheating. Finally, I'll delete the Docker file from my local code. Now all I have are my main Go program and the go.mod file that Go requires. So to deploy to Cloud Run with the source-based workflow, all I need to do is run gcloud run deploy --source and specify the location of my source code. This time, it guesses the service name based on the name of the directory where my code exists. Using the source-based workflow, we'll create a new repository for the containers that it will build, and this will be created in the new artifact registry. Finally, I'll have to confirm again that I want to allow unauthenticated invocations to my web service. And now Cloud Run will work its magic. It will create the container repository, upload my source code, build my container image, and then create the service in Cloud Run, along with the traffic and IAM policies. Container images built by Cloud Run use the open source Build Packs project, which is definitely worth checking out. All I've had to do is provide my application code. The command returns, and my application has been deployed. Here's my new service URL. And here's my deployed web app, straight from source code. That concludes this lab demonstration.